Excited to get the win, always. Really excited about some of the things we did running the football today. And not 100%, but I thought we did some really good things. Really excited about our second half, both defensively and offensively. And you know, our charge is to play that way at the start of the game, and we're working towards that. But we beat a good football team today. Missouri State is growing and getting better, and I was happy with the win.
So we'll go ahead and open it up for questions.
John, Brady Mangarelli, I asked him what sort of the message was at halftime, whether you had kind of got after them or anything. He said it was more just the coaches saying that you were disappointed with how they were playing, but they were beating themselves. Can you expound a little bit on what that message was?
Well, just go out and do your job, you know, I try to not be negative, you know. I try to find things to work on and focus on that are positive. And our guys responded, you know. Our coaches did a good job of adjusting some stuff at halftime. I thought our defense, I mean, they went from 220 yards from 220 in the first half to a little over 100 in the second half. So great job by them. Again, we got to have to do that in the first half, and then it's a dominating victory if we can play like that for a whole game.
Was there a feeling at halftime that, hey, we should be ahead by more than 4 points right now?
I think there was a confidence. I think we've created that confidence as a team because of some of the things we've done offensively and defensively at times. But I don't know. They knew Missouri State was a good football team. They also knew they got two touchdowns and two big plays, essentially. You know, the post where we fell down, and then the tunnel screen where we couldn't tackle. And so there's a confidence there. But you got to give him credit.
I asked Dave Steckel about the fake punt and kind of trying to piece together what he said, more or less that they saw a look from you guys where they felt like every time they're in this look, they do this, and then you didn't, and obviously it completely backfired on them. He kind of almost made it sound like maybe you kind of sandbagged him a little bit, showed him something that you don't usually. Is he reading into that? Or
when they ran their rugby punt, we had one guy on four guys, their punter and three guys, because our other guy was getting pinned. And we talked about it. And we would have adjusted, but we wouldn't have had eight guys there like we had in that play. We just called a punt block. So he was right. That's what coaches do. This is what they do. They've done it 3-4 times. Let's do this. And it's a chess game, and sometimes you're much better than the other move. So.
Fair enough to say that was a pretty big play in the game.
Huge play. Huge play in the football game. That third quarter was a huge quarter in the football game, both in terms of production and discouraging them.
Kyle Paris getting back into the game, was that in part a reaction to, you guys have struggled on some 4th-and-1s and 3rd-and-1s and that kind of thing, was that part of why he got back in there?
Part of that, you know, we had a more of a Mikey Daniels package, a big guy package, and he went down, and the next guy, you know, they said on the headphones is Kyle, and Kyle has always done that. When his number's been called, he's never responded, and unfortunately, he's got a couple good guys in front of him. But that's one of the things that makes me most happy about this win is his production.
4th-and-1 has been a struggle for you guys at times this year. Is there something you can do better on those 4th-and-short plays?
You know, I have to look at the film on the one we ran. That we got stopped on, and obviously you tell your running back to hit it downhill, and he went lateral, and he said he was following the guard. Most of the time, if you hit the line of scrimmage and there's somebody there, you're still going to get a yard if you go straight ahead. When you run lateral, it's tough.
Are you hesitant to go under center in plays like that just because you hardly ever do it during games?
Yeah, it's just not us. And I tell you what, if we went under center, they'd probably think we're sneaking the ball, which we don't do. So. And we might put that in and run power from that. So,
USD next week. I mean, will you try as hard as you can to keep this week normal? You know, not treat it any different than another opponent.
We've never done that. Last year with the North Dakota State game, I built it up too big, and our guys were tight, and we got beat by a good football team last year. But this year, you know the story. We approach it like it's a Missouri Valley. We need to be 1-0. We played some good football, so I expect we'll do that. Our guys are aware of that rivalry, but it still isn't as deep as it used to be. So we'll do some talking about the history of that rivalry.
Thank you.